So you would be okay with the Supreme Court leaving the question of interracial marriage to the states?
Yes, I think that that's something that if you're not wanting the Supreme Court to weigh in on issues like that, you're not going to be able to have your cake and eat it too. I think that's hypocritical.
What about Griswold versus Connecticut?
Well, you can list a whole host of issues. When it comes down to whatever they are, I'm going to say that they're not going to all make you happy within a given state, but that we're better off having states manifest their points of view rather than homogenizing it across the country as Roe versus Wade did.
So that is Senator Mike Braun, who in this nationwide conversation that we're having on the SCOTUS and what judicial philosophy we want to run America, where our priorities should lie, he gets drawn into literally saying, no, I think if states want to outlaw interracial marriage, it's not on the federal government to decide that they can't do that. And look, rightfully people are focusing on the interracial marriage part. I think it's obvious that's insane, but they also get into things about access to contraceptives. And there's a long list of topics he's apparently perfectly fine with throwing back to the states. And Brett, we can have, I think, a debate about areas where states should be able to decide. We are, after all, we're a country set up. We're not France or whatever. We delegate certain powers to the states. It's a different way of doing things. But we also expect, and I think are allowed to demand, that there's a base level of protection and respect for human rights, human dignity. And we should not simply consign people to hope your state acts rights. Maybe you'll have rights. Maybe or maybe not. Maybe you should move. No, this is still a country. We are allowed to have standards. And literally not being barred from marrying someone of a different race feels like it falls below that threshold.
Yeah, the reason it got to the Supreme Court is someone had to do that. What the Supreme Court does. And frequently the Supreme Court will go back and be like, all right, Congress, you got to do a law. Or that the congressional law was an overreach, fine. But if this guy, this is what's horrifying and or hilarious. This guy thinks he's nailing an argument.
Yeah.
And that argument is that it was a mistake to say, hey, enough's enough. You should be able to marry someone who's of a different race in the United States. And he thinks it is a great argument to say, listen, if South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia wants to make it illegal and annul your marriage the minute you cross the state line, yep. Well, that's up to them. That fundamental premise that there should be rules on a federal level is not only the Constitution, that's what it does, but also specifically when it comes to your rights, the Bill of Rights, the amendments to the Constitution, they're like, all right, those rules for setting things up, what the judiciary, the other branches of government does is good. But we also got to write down, before I sign on to this country you want, we got to write down things that no matter how crazy the states get.
Yeah.
No, that's what it says. The amendments, you don't know what the 7th, 8th, 9th Amendment does. Those are the ones that are like, all right, the rest of this stuff we leave up to the states. But fundamental guarantees of rights, that's what the Bill of Rights does. And that's frequently what the decisions of the Supreme Court are all about. Does this state policy run in conflict to the things we enumerated as things you can't violate with state laws?
Yeah, and if you are relatively new to American politics and you think, well, why would you need federal protections against these things? I mean, literally, you're talking about them making interracial marriage illegal. They would never. I don't know. They're about to overturn Roe v. Wade after more than half a century of that being a guaranteed right. They want to relitigate all of that. They're literally banning talking about the fact that gay people exist and that slavery was a thing, that racism you think we're advancing. No, there is advancement, but there's also a splitting going on. Many of these areas would willfully jump off a cliff into ignorance and religious dogma and all of that. By the way, AOC rightfully pointed out this Mike Braun thing, And we're going to give you the update. She said, "Can journalists please not pretend it's normal for a US senator to declare that the Supreme Court was wrong to legalize interracial marriage? He's okay with it being illegal now. His new statement not walking anything back during a SCOTUS nomination that he'd be voting on. Thanks." So let's get to that statement, because there's been a lot of criticism of Mike Braun. He said, "I misunderstood a line of questioning that ended up being about interracial marriage. Let me be clear on that issue. There is no question the Constitution prohibits discrimination of any kind based on race. That is not something that is even up for debate. And I condemn racism in any form at all levels and by any states, entities, or individuals." He didn't comment, by the way, on whether he also misunderstood the line of questioning on Roe or Griswold, or how what he just said actually fits with his original statement. It's not like there was ambiguity to the question or to the answer. He specifically said the Supreme Court shouldn't be getting involved. He's attempting to reverse it and claiming that he's anti-racist in all of these different areas, none of which he'd identify as racism, by the way. That's the evasion that they have. "I hate racism," which thankfully we banished when we elected Barack Obama as president. But she points out that doesn't actually walk back what he says. He needs to go on record to clarify whether he believes states should be allowed to reinstate anti-miscegenation laws and whether it's believed SCOTUS should overturn Loving v. Virginia, as he does with Roe v. Wade, because he's not actually saying any of those things. He would like you to back off and stop pressuring him, but he does actually stand by what he said, because that is reflective of a lot of Republicans' positions on these issues.
The Constitution, there's a lot of reasons why the Constitution prohibits discrimination based on race, but the operative term I would add is it bans the discrimination based on race now. Now it does, because originally it said that black people were 3/5 of a human being. Mm-hmm. In the Constitution of the United States of America. And thanks to the activism, Civil War suffragists, and basically progressive ideology in action, and the Supreme Court making judgments on same, now it's not okay to discriminate based on race. And without, and if he got his way, it would never be able to do that going forward.
Exactly. Yeah, no, they want us to go backward, and they will occasionally admit that openly. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.